Hello everyone. In this video lecture, let us understand Module 3, Data Flow Modeling. In this lecture, let us understand the continuous assignment statement in Verilog. Verilog HDL has different levels of abstractions like the gate level abstraction, the data flow modeling, the behavioral modeling, the switch level modeling. So previously we just saw that gate level modeling is a one-to-one translation of a gate into a Verilog HDL statement, that is a gate instantiation. As the design becomes complex, the number of gates increases. So writing a Verilog gate level modeling becomes very difficult. So if we have a design with say millions of transistors or millions of gates, then the code would also have millions of gate instantiations, and definitely the gate level modeling starts becoming difficult. So we look into a second type of modeling known as the data flow modeling. So in data flow modeling, we can design a circuit in terms of the data flow between the registers than the instantiations of the individual gates. So basically, in data flow modeling, we are going to model how the data flows from the input to the output through a Boolean expression. So instead of instantiating each and every gate, the entire logic gate diagram will have a Boolean expression. So we can describe the code in terms of a Boolean expression, and that is data flow modeling. When we write a Boolean expression, we have an assignment statement. So in data flow modeling, we have a continuous assignment statement. So as the name itself tells, continuous. So continuous assignment statement basically drives a value onto a net, because we know that the value on a net keeps changing continuously. Net is a wire. So it will replace all the gate instantiations, and it will just describe the circuit at a higher level of abstraction by just writing one Boolean equation. So in data flow modeling, a continuous assignment statement, it starts with the keyword assign. So assign is a keyword which highlights it is a data flow modeling. And the syntax of writing this assignment statement is, we write the keyword assign followed by the drive strength and the delay. These two parameters, the drive strength and the delay, are optional. And then we write the Boolean expression, which is the list of assignments. So let us see some of the characteristics of a continuous assignment statement in Verilog. So since it is an assignment statement, it is a Boolean expression, the expression will have an LHS and an RHS. So let us see the rules governing to write a continuous assignment statement in Verilog. So the first rule is, or the first characteristic here is, the left hand side of the assignment statement, it must always be a scalar or a vector net. Or it can be a concatenation of scalar and vector nets, but it cannot be a register. So the meaning is, the left hand side must always be a wire, it can never be a register. It can be a one bit wire, that is scalar, or it can be multiple bit wire, that is vector, or it can be a concatenation of one bit and multiple bit wire. The second rule is, continuous assignment statements, as the name tells, they are always active. So the assignment on the right hand side is evaluated, it's as soon as the operands changes, and once it is evaluated or calculated, that value is assigned to the LHS of the net. This task happens continuously. The operands on the RHS, so the RHS of the equation, the Boolean expression, can be registers, or it can be wires nets, or it can be function calls also. So RHS can be registers or nets or function calls. And in an assignment statement, we can mention delay values if necessary in terms of the time units. So these are the characteristics of a continuous assignment statement. Let us see some of the examples of a continuous assignment statement in Verilog. Let us assume we have three variables named out, I1 and I2. And all three variables are nets, meaning to say they are wires. So if we need to relate these three variables with a Boolean expression, let's say the AND operation, the bitwise AND, the statement to be written in data flow modeling is, write the keyword assign, out is equal to I1 and I2. So the first rule tells, the LHS must be a wire. Yes, it is a wire. The RHS can be a register or a wire or a function call. It is a wire here. And they can be one bit or multiple bit. Let's do one more continuous assignment statement for vector bit. So this was for scalar bit, that is one bit. So let us assume we have a variable named address ADDR, which is a 16-bit vector net. So it is a wire, but it is multiple bit, which is 16-bit. And we have two more variables, ADDR1, address 1 and address 2, which are 16-bit vector registers. So ADDR1 and ADDR2 can appear on the RHS because they are registers, but this ADDR can, which is a net, can appear on the left hand side. So let's see one assignment statement. So there is no particular logic for this particular statement. We've just taken one random operation. So since it is declared as a 16-bit vector, so the keyword assign, on the left hand side we have the net ADDR. We have mentioned all the 16 bits. We can skip writing this if we have already declared it as a vector and mentioned the size earlier. So we are observing here ADDR1 bits is 15:0. That's all the 16 bits of ADDR1 is XORed with all the 16 bits of ADDR2. This result is then stored onto the ADDR wire. So this shows that we can use scalar or vector nets and registers. And one more point in the characteristic set, it can be the concatenation. The LHS can be a concatenation of a scalar and a vector net. So we can take an example like this, assuming cout and sum are wires. So we have observed here sum 3:0. So this is a vector bit, multiple bits. 3 down to 0 means totally 4 bits. So this is a 4-bit variable sum, and cout is a single bit variable. So we have concatenated using this curly braces operator and making it a 5-bit. So the left hand side can be a concatenation of wires of single bit and multiple bit. So we have written the keyword assign concatenation equal to the operation, that is addition of A, 4 bits of A with 4 bits of B plus C in input. Now we have another type of continuous assignment statement known as the implicit continuous assignment. So normally we have to declare a net and then write a continuous assignment on the net. So there's a shortcut. Net is nothing but a wire. There's a shortcut for this. Regular continuous assignment happens something like this. We declare a wire out and then we can write assign out is equal to I1 and I2 because the left hand side must be a net. Also note that by default all input and output variables behave like net. We can declare them as registers. So an output variable declared can be directly written on the left hand side even without this wire declaration. So instead of writing a wire declaration and then writing this statement, we can do implicitly a continuous assignment statement. So the above two lines can be combined and we can just write it in one line, just like write the keyword wire. Write out is equal to I1 and I2. So this is also an assignment statement, but there is no assign keyword. So it is implicitly understood it is a continuous assignment statement because of this keyword wire, because we know wire is a net which whose value changes continuously. So this is also an assignment statement. So instead of writing these two, we can write a single line, which is the implicit continuous assignment. Delays can also be mentioned in an assignment statement. So under the characteristics and in the syntax, we saw that delays can be mentioned after the keyword assign before we write the Boolean expression. So let us see how delays can be mentioned. So basically delay values will control the time between the change in an RHS operand and when the value will be assigned to the LHS. So there are three ways of specifying delays in continuous assignment statements. So the first method is the regular assignment delay. The second method is the implicit continuous assignment delay. And the third delay is the net declaration delay. Let us look into each one of them individually with an example. First, let us understand the regular assignment delay. So we all know assigning a delay in a normal continuous assignment statement is the regular method. Delays in Verilog will be mentioned using the hash symbol. The delay value is specified after the keyword assign. So we can observe here. So previously we just wrote assign out is equal to I1 and I2. Now we can observe we have included this hash 10, which tells after 10 time units you assign this value I1 and I2, the calculated value, onto out variable. So we have introduced a delay parameter. So this is a regular assignment delay where you just introduce the delay with a hash symbol after the keyword assign. So what is the change that is going to happen here is, let us assume we have I1, I2 values. So this is a normal AND operation. So initially I1 and I2, if we notice, both turn out to be a 0. So at this point, I1 is also 0, input 2 is also 0. So 0 and 0, we expect this result to be a 0. But we have told, we have mentioned a hash 10 delay over here. So after 10 time units, we can observe here, after 10 time units, this calculated value 0 and 0 is assigned to the variable out over here. So everything gets delayed. Similarly, 0 and 0, the next cycle, we can observe it will be assigned on the next instance after 10 time units. So the delay 10 to 20 can be observed here. So if we observe at the timing instant 20, both the inputs are 1 and 1, input 1 and input 2. But if we observe at 20, the output remains at 0. After 10 time units, the output calculated value has changed to 1 now. So that is the impact of including a delay like hash 10, or any number can be introduced depending on the requirement. So this is a normal regular assignment delay where we just include a hash and a delay value after the keyword assign. The second type of delay is the implicit continuous assignment delay. So an implicit continuous assignment delay is, we are going to specify both a delay and an assignment on the net. Let's understand this with an example. So we saw previously what is an implicit continuous assignment statement. So an implicit continuous assignment statement was one where we just wrote wire out is equal to I1 and I2. We did not write assignment statement. So to this statement, if we add a number, a delay hash 10 like this after the keyword wire, this becomes implicit continuous assignment delay. So excluding this hash 10, this is an implicit continuous assignment statement. Including this delay, this becomes implicit continuous assignment delay. So this is equivalent to writing separately wire out assign hash 10 out is equal to I1 and I2. So this is a regular assignment delay. So in regular assignment delay, instead of taking two lines, implicit method, we can directly do it on a single line, not without writing the keyword assign. So during the declaration line itself, we can write the assignment. The third type of delay is the net declaration delay. So in net declaration delay, we can specify a delay at the time of the declaration of a net. Net is a wire. So when we are declaring a wire, we can mention a delay to that particular variable. So in that case, when we mention the delay when it is being declared, even without writing the Boolean expression or the continuous assignment statement, that is a net declaration delay. And when we mention in such a case a delay on the net out variable, then any value change will be applied to the net out, it will be delayed accordingly. Let us understand this with an example. So net declarations, they can be used also with a gate level modeling. So now observe here, we just write wire out. Just writing wire out is a declaration. At the time of declaration, if we are including a delay, this is a net declaration delay, because when we write only wire out, it is net declaration. When we include a delay into this line, this becomes net declaration delay. So what is the effect of this statement is, when you write assign out is equal to I1 and I2, this statement has the same effect as we wrote the first statement. So this is equivalent to writing assign hash 10 out is equal to I1 and I2. How? Because when we have declared out, we have told any value to out must be delayed by 10 time units. So even though we have not explicitly mentioned here, this delay will be applied to this variable wherever it is mentioned in the program or the code. So I1 and I2 is calculated, but it will be assigned 10 time units later. So this is net declaration delay. So in this lecture video, we understood what is a continuous assignment statement, what are the different types of delay in Verilog. Thank you.